fuses. Those are for plug tops, and they are manufactured to British Standard 1362. There are a selection of sizes up in front of the camera there, some of which a lot of people don't know about, but they are available because there they are up in front of the camera. Okay. Now, those go in your plug tops, and the one which is absent from that little lineup, okay, is the 1 amp. All of the others are there. We've got the 2, the 3, the 5, 7, 10, and 13. They're all there, except that 1 amp. I do have one, but I can't seem to find it, which is a little disappointing because it could go in that little lineup to the left end. Okay, you can clearly see on the video picture there that the one to the far left is a 2 amp. Okay. Now, I'm just going to move a few of those forwards because what I'm going to do is show, firstly, the most well-known ones, the most popular, familiar ones. Okay. So, first of all then, the 3 amp and the 13 amp. Like so. Right, those are the most well known. This one is, let me just get a zoom out on a minute, hold on. Zoomed right the way in on that. Okay, right, what have we got? Just adjusting that camera. Right, that is a 3 amp fuse. Okay, I don't know if you will get all on the details on that. Probably not. Oh, I don't know though. 3 amp, and then it's, you've got the Aster little logo underneath, and then you've got the British Standard, what's called a kite mark underneath that. Then it says British Standard 1362, made in England. And that's made by Busman, that one. And there you go, back to 3 amp. So I'll keep my finger there and just whip the fuse out. And then put another one in. Like so. That shouldn't cause any problems with the zoom. But this one is been roped this way up. This one is made by MK. Okay, one of my subscribers did actually ask me some time back whether MK do make their own plug top fuses. Up in front of the camera there, people, is the confirmation that they do. Okay, MK plug top fuses to British Standard 1362. So there it is. MK 13 amp, and it says down the bottom there, British Standard 1362. And up the top there's the rating at 13 amps. Okay. So there it is. Funnily enough, being MK, it doesn't put any of the fancy logos on it, like the Aster certification and the kite, the British Standard kite mark. It just gets straight to the chase. Because a lot of people know and trust that logo right there. That's the MK logo. That's the more recent, modern, up-to-date MK logo. Okay, quite a recently manufactured fuse, that one. So if I put that back with that little 3 amp one, there we go. Don't worry about those other fuses you've just seen, because those are not in this video. We are concentrating on those up in front of the camera there. The two that are mostly towards the camera there, those are the most well-known ones. Okay, if I just move those apart a little bit, another rating that's known by some is this one. Let me zoom that camera out again. We'll have a look at it. There it is. 5 amp. I believe, is that going to get on it? There you go, 5 amp. Again, it's got the ASTA certification underneath that, the little logo, and the British Standard kite bark. I had that earlier, why is it not zooming it now? There we go. There's the ASTA logo and the British Standard kite bark. So it's right there. What's that say underneath it? Oh, made in England. Again, I'm viewing this on a little 2-inch screen on the back of the camera. Okay, down in the corner of your screen, down there in that corner, there's a button. If you press that, it'll bring this up full size on your computer screen. So it says made in England there. If I turn it around a bit more, what else does it say? The standard, British Standard 1362. And it is made by VF. Okay, so that is another rating that's known by some, but not as familiar and popular as the 3 amp and the 13 amp. Okay, so there we go. So let's put that back in the little lineup. Zoom that camera in. There they are. Okay, so that then leaves those ones right up the back there against the wall, to the left. Okay, not these ones at the front here, but the ones right at the back. To the left we got 2 amp. Once again, I will say that you can get a 1 amp. I do have one, but I cannot seem to find it. Okay, bit of a shame that, because well, I could show that up in front of the camera in this little lineup, but I cannot seem to find it. Little disappointing that. As I'm going to do with all the other fuses, I'm going to bring it up in front of the camera now. We'll have a more in detailed look at it, and you'll be surprised at the manufacturer of that 2 amp fuse. Okay, let's zoom that camera out. Okay, so this one says on it, 2 amp. Okay, there it is. British Standard 1362 again down the bottom there. And who made this fuse? Pop. Yep, there it is, people. There's an MK fuse, and that is the more older MK logo on that. Okay. So there you go, that is definitely the confirmation that MK did manufacture their own plug top fuses. 2 amp. Once again, made to British Standard 1362. There it is, it says it on there, just up top there. 2 amp. Next up, we got the 7 amp one. Now, until very recently, even I didn't know this one existed. Pop. 7 amp. That fuse is live, it does work. I've run out of cup of tea. So, 7 amp. Once again, it's got the all the logos down the bottom there. The little Aster logo, the kite mark logo, and there's even a logo down there from the manufacturer themselves. British Standard 1362, made in England. Again. Okay. And then there's a really long number on that. That might be a part number or something. It doesn't pertain to the fuse at all. But I'll read the number out, and it says on it BP116 7583. Okay, so there we go, and I believe that says alert. on there. That's the manufacturer of the fuse right there. Okay. 7 amp. It does say British Standard 1362 on it. So there we go. I don't know if you just heard that in the background, but Toby is talking to one of his kittens. Right, I'm just going to, because I've messed them fuses up. Just, I'm just rearranging those fuses a minute, people. Hold on, bear with me. Because I've got to keep them in sequence for the closing shots, which is going to be in a couple of minutes or so. Okay, next one. Pop. Is it going to focus? Yes, it is. There you go. 10 amp, that one. Okay. British Standard 1362 again. And down the bottom it says ASTA cert. And I think you've just noticed the logo on that. Once again, it's MK. Toby is talking quite well to one of his kittens upstairs. So there we go. MK 10 amp plug top fuse. Okay, made to British Standard 1362 again. And there it is. Okay. So, what are the kind of currents you can draw through those fuses? Well, I'm just going to go through them now. There they are. Okay, now the voltages, the currents that I'm going to quote for those fuses are in reference to a voltage of 240 volts. Okay, so to start with then, you've obviously got the 1 amp fuse, which is not present up in front of the camera. Can you just hold on a minute there, people? Okay, I've just got to show this, because he's really giving it some. He wants a piece of action on the camera. Do excuse this, this is slightly off topic. But look at this. What have you got, Tobias? What have you got? You've brought a kitten. You've brought me a kitten. There's number three, people. And that's what Toby does with his kittens. He brings them down. And, yeah, there's number three. Toby's brought me a kitten. I'm not sure if you heard all that chirruping on the camera, but this is what Toby does. He hooks his kittens out and he carries them down the stairs. And he says, you know, he talks to them. He says, I brought you a kitten. Okay. Look, there's number three. Okay, I'm going to leave him there. Okay, so it's a bit off topic in regards to fuses, but he's such a little rebel for trying to get in on a piece of action on the camera. Okay, he knows I've got the video camera rolling and he starts creating. So for 14 minutes, as I was going to say, with those fuses up in front of the camera there, before Toby started talking to number three, I'm going to give you the wattages that you can pull through those fuses, okay? The ratings that I'm going to give are quoted at 240 volts. So first of all then, the 1 amp fuse, you can pull 240 watts through that, okay? That's normally, I don't know what it would take to blow it, it'll probably be like 300 watts or something like that. Next up, the 2 amp fuse, that would be 480 watts going through that one. Okay, that would quite happily take 480 watts. The 3 amp fuse, that would be 720 watts, this one. Okay, then you've got the 5 amp one, that is 1,200 watts. Okay, the 7 amp one, I will just need a calculator for that one, because I don't have that one internally stored. Hold on a moment. Such a rarity as a 7-amp fuse that I don't have that rating internally stored. 7 times 240, that would be 1,680 watts for the 7-amp fuse. Okay. And then you got the 10-amp fuse, which would be 2,400 watts. And then the 13-amp fuse, which would be 3,120 watts. Okay. To my annoyance, even though those fuses are domestic fuses, how can I word this? Well, basically, for anyone who's got a copy of 17th edition wiring regulations to British Standard 7671, if you go through that book and you look at the disconnection curves in the back there for fuses, you can get in there British Standard 1361, British Standard 88, British Standard 3036. No of those up in front of the camera there. They do not list the disconnection curves for British Standard 1362, and I am disappointed with that. Okay. You know, they put British Standard 1361, which is consumer unit fuses, and British Standard 3036, and British Standard 88, and all that, but not those up in front of the camera there, and that peeves me off, because it would really be really nice to know the disconnection curves of all that lot. Okay? So, yes. I would like that to be added into the wiring regulations, 17th edition, British Standard 7671. Because, just to wrap this video up, I'm going to show a few applications now of those fuses up in front of the camera there. We're going to take this to 20 minutes, I think. Okay then, the first and most obvious one is a plug top. This one's already fused. Pop. There you go. Okay. Those fuses, those little wee cartridge fuses, ignore those. These ones. Okay. There. Those obviously are fitted into one of those. There's a 13-amp plug top, okay. You take the cutback cover off and the fuse would go about there, okay, in the plug top. There's loads of people that have done how to wire a 13-amp plug on YouTube. You know, that plug does go to our kettle base, okay. So, those fuses there, which I've just shown, those ones, it looks like that's hitting that fuse, but it's not. Those fuses that I've just shown, other applications for those fuses, they include these. We do have one in the kitchen. Let me just zoom that camera out. Okay. There's the washing machine. Now, you can, when you connect the washing machine up, if you look just down the side there, I don't know if I'll be able to get it, but there's a standard wall socket down there with a 13-amp plug connected into it. Now, you can connect those into a ring circuit on something called a spur. Okay. When you do, you can use one of these. There it is. Okay. A switched fused spur. Okay, you've got the switch on there, there's a little neon light. That one does have a flex outlet on it, as shown underneath there. It's not used. And just there, there's a fuse in there. British Standard 1362. Okay. I'm going to get a screwdriver, I'm going to dig that out and take a look at it. Okay, the power is off. Okay. So let's dig that fuse out and have a look at it. Little screwdriver. Where's the little screwdriver? There's a little screwdriver. There's a little gap just down there. Put your screwdriver in there and give it a look, a little bit of crowbar action. And it comes out just like that. Okay. Let me just wind that camera up a bit. I know I said 20 minutes, and it's gone past 20 minutes, hasn't it? You know how all videos waffle on. But there we go. That just pops out like that. And then you just carefully get your fingers in there. Little bit of persuasion with the screwdriver. And there's a fuse. 13 amp, because there's a washing machine on that. Oh, it's a crab tree. That's interesting. It's a crab tree fuse. That accessory there is made by Crabtree. Okay. Where is it? I'm going to try and get on this. That's a 13 amp Crabtree fuse. There it is. 13 amp Crabtree. It says 13 amp on it. There's the ASTA logo again there. The ASTA logo. British Standard 1362, made in England. Okay, now that MB down there, I don't know what that means, but there it is. But that's a Crabtree one. So there you go, Crabtree made their own plug top fuses as well. And that fuse normally lives in there. A switched fused spur. Let's turn it on. There you go. You see a little neon light glowing in there. So for 22 minutes, people, thanks for watching.